Most brides worry about a few pressing wedding day concerns, like hair and makeup, and whether a relative will make a drunken embarrassment out of themselves on the dance floor. But for Zanelle and Lovu, her biggest worry was whether or not she would even be alive to make it down the aisle to wed her future husband. Because in a horrifying turn of events, the bride-to-be lost her arm in a crocodile attack just 5 days before she was set to marry her longtime love. But she had the determination beyond all reason to make it down the aisle. So Enlovu pulled through and is allegedly now, happier than she was before, the mauling. Zanelle Enlovu is a 25-year-old former Zimbabwean national tennis player who had the terrible misfortune of taking an ill-fated river trip just 5 days before her wedding. Set to marry her British-born fiancé Jamie Foxx, Enlovu had no idea when stepping into her inflatable boat that her life would be threatened by a hungry crocodile. While canoeing with her future husband on the Zambezi River, Enlovu was savagely bitten on her right arm by a crocodile lurking just below the water's surface. Instantly, the 25-year-old was pulled underwater and tossed about like a rag doll. "My first thought was, I am going to die," she admitted. The water was now bloody. Unwilling to watch his longtime love be mauled to death in front of him, Foxx jumped in the water to save his fiancé. "Jamie swam over to where I was struggling with the crocodile that was trying to pull me to the bottom of the river and grabbed my waist, and with the other hand he rained blows down on the crocodile," said Enlovu. "The pain was excruciating, but Jamie was by my side and I summoned the strength to fight through it." Before the attack, the couple was relaxed and happy to take in the breathtaking scenery around them. "We had no fears at all, but they, the guides, did mention that we would see a couple of crocodiles, but they didn't warn us that they could attack us, so we were quite relaxed. We were not expecting anything like that to happen," said Enlovu. After Foxx was able to drive the croc away, Enlovu was terrified that she would die floating in the bloody river at the sight of the attack. "There was a lot of panic, a lot of crying, and it felt like forever until the helicopters arrived and we were able to move on to hospital," said Foxx. In addition to losing her arm, doctors treated her broken ribs and fractured left hand. While surgeons were thankfully able to save Enlovu's life, they were forced to amputate her shredded arm. Making the process of losing her limb easier, the 25-year-old knew her arm was no longer functional long before she passed through hospital doors. "There was just a piece of skin keeping it together, so I kind of had an idea, and it wasn't a shock to me when they had to amputate it," she revealed. Determined to become husband and wife, Enlovu and Foxx quickly made alternate arrangements for their wedding. "We had always planned for our wedding to be on May 5th, said Foxx, willing to marry his bride-to-be in the hospital chapel in order to keep their previously set date. With just 5 days between the attack and the wedding, the soon-to-be married couple were definitely put to the test before exchanging vows. "I spent most of the days before the wedding crying with her family and my family, and I wanted to try and make sure I didn't cry on the wedding day because it was such a happy occasion for us both, though I definitely got choked up as she came down the aisle in her dress," said Foxx. Surprisingly, Enlovu has already adopted an incredibly positive outlook regarding her days ahead. "I still enjoy being outside and trying new things, but maybe not canoeing anymore and not on the Zambezi," she admitted. "I am so grateful to be alive because I was so close to death, and I am happier than I was before." In response to the attack, Zimbabwe game rangers shot and killed the offending crocodile. "We have since managed to track and kill the crocodile because since it tasted human blood, it was bound to be a problem," said Tinashe Farawo, spokesperson for the Zimbabwe Parks and Wildlife Management Authority.
If you enjoyed this story, then wait for our next story starting in 10 seconds.
For a lucky 20-year-old named Shane Missler from Florida's Gulf Coast, the dream of winning the lottery became reality. So what happens when a millennial kid wins a huge jackpot? One morning in January 2018, Shane Missler sat down with his dad for some coffee. It seemed like just another typical day. But little did Missler's dad know that his 20-year-old son was hiding a huge secret. And I mean huge. Missler lives in Port Richey, which is a suburb of Tampa, Florida. He's been living in the Sunshine State for a few years now, but the Missler family was originally from Maine, New England. Being just another normal young man, Missler had no idea that his life was about to change forever. Missler loves playing the lottery all the time. In fact, he credits his amazing good luck to the power of positive thinking, which he feels should never be underestimated under any circumstances. But how did he get so lucky? Let's see how everything started. Missler went to the 7-Eleven at 7131 Ridge Road in Pasco County on Friday, Jan. 5 to pick up some extra money from a scratch-off ticket he won a few days earlier. But he had no idea how much things were about to change. Believe it or not, there was no special meaning in the numbers he picked since Missler had used the quick pick option. This meant that the numbers were chosen at random completely, and he won against some seriously major, astronomical odds. His reaction when he found out that he won? Priceless. The euphoric Missler went on Facebook and wrote, "Oh. My. God." His brother was the first person he called to share the good news with, but there was someone else he needed to call ASAP. The following morning, Missler met up with his dad over some coffee. He decided that it was a lot better to tell his dad in person, rather than breaking the news to him over the phone. His dad's reaction? It was beyond expected. As if winning the lottery wasn't totally bonkers enough, Missler also learned that he had been the sole winner. This meant that he wouldn't have to share the jackpot's grand total with absolutely anybody else. Wait until you see how much money he won. People on social media offered plenty of advice, but one in particular struck a chord. Get a priest, lawyers, financial advisors. So, Missler decided that getting a lawyer would be a good idea since he had no idea how he'd manage so much money. Then he did this. Missler, his Navy vet dad, and his lawyer, Walt Blenner, decided to turn in the ticket together. So, the three of them safely jetted over to Tallahassee, the home of the Florida Lottery headquarters, to claim the coveted prize. Blenner, who once helped a man who won a $3 million scratch-off, offered some words of advice. He told Missler, "Your old life is gone and you can never go back to that life. It will never be the same." And he was right. Winners of Mega Millions can either take their cash prize in 30 annual installments or receive a lower lump sum. Missler chose the lower lump sum, which brought his prize money down to $281,874,999. Yes, you read that right. And that's not all. The Florida Lottery Commission was also required to withhold 25% of that lump sum for federal income taxes, which brought his total take-home money down even lower to $211,406,249.25. Still, he was filthy rich and he has great plans on what he'd end up doing with his money. Before winning the lottery, Missler worked as a verification specialist at Universal Background Screening, Inc. But with his millions, he was finally able to fulfill our dreams and ended up quitting in order to focus on his own future. Missler followed his lawyer's advice and had LTTERY officials deposit the money in a trust called Secret 007, LLC, which will allow him to manage his own money. Missler had won a whopping $450 million from the Mega Millions jackpot. According to Florida Lottery officials, it was the Mega Millions' fourth largest jackpot prize given in its history. With the money from the scratch-off ticket, he bought 5 Mega Millions quick pick tickets, one of which was the winning lottery ticket that would turn him into an instant freaking millionaire overnight. The drawing took place the night of Jan. 5, and the winning numbers were 28, 30, 39, 59, 70 and the Mega Ball number 10. Lucky Missler learned he was the winner just a half hour later. To say he went ballistic is an understatement. Missler told the Tampa Bay Times, "I've had a crash course this week in financial management and I feel so fortunate to have this incredible wealth and team behind me." Now that he was learning how to handle so much cash, he had to sit down and decide what was in store next. Shane has proven to his followers that he's wise beyond his years. Understandably, he intends to have a little fun along the way, while planning for financial success as well. "I intend to take care of my family, have some fun along the way and cement a path for financial success," he told Tampa Bay Times. Shane's old high school coach, Larry Thornton, doesn't see Shane going off the rails either, as he thinks he's mature enough to handle this stroke of luck. "He's going to find out what he needs to do and how he's going to do it," he told Tampa Bay. After Shane won, someone pretending to be him created a Twitter account claiming he would give $5,000 to the first 50,000 followers who retweeted and liked his post. People fell for that ridiculous stunt, but only for a bit. The claim was a total scam, obviously. Whoever started this hoax was only trying to take advantage of Shane's popularity. This prompted Shane to make a statement about his only real accounts on Twitter and Instagram. "Shane won't give away $5,000 to his followers anytime soon, I mean, hello. But he does plan on exploring his passions and taking care of his loved ones." He said, "I hope to use it to pursue a variety of passions, help my family and do some good for humanity. We can't wait to hear about what he's up to in the near future."